A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14 September, on the front page you have 312 Indian origin Sikhs removed from post-militancy adverse list. So Home Ministry's list has had debarred them earlier and their kin from applying for Indian visa. But now these 312 Indian origin Sikhs living in foreign countries have been removed from this adverse list. Then this is odd even scheme back in Delhi from November 4 to 15. So part of the 7-point action plan to combat air pollution, the Delhi government and the Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has brought back the odd even scheme, in which on odd dates, odd number cars on one date and even number cars on even dates would be plying on the roads. So that will reduce the number of vehicles on the roads and the pollution thereof. Then below you have Rajasthan launches information portal. So this is first time that a state has put up such a portal in which citizens can access details pertaining to 13 departments. So this is the first ever public information portal launched. It has been named Jan Suchna Portal 2019. On page 9 you have government has failed to bring in uniform civil code, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has said that the constitution framers had hoped for uniform set of rules, but the government has failed to bring out a uniform civil code. So this is, you can see, a bench of Justice Deepak Gupta and Anirudh Bose who observed this in a judgment they delivered. Then below you have Meet ends with vow to curb land degradation. So this is United Nations conference to combat desertification. So the 2-week long conference which took place in India ended with commitment to achieve land degradation neutrality by 2030. So this is defined by UN as neutrality is defined as ensuring that enough land is available across the world to ensure a sustainable future. So the Delhi Declaration has come forth. It's a consensus document agreed upon by more than 100 countries, and it has welcomed the proposed adoption of a voluntary land degradation neutrality target by India as well. India has committed to restoring at least 26 million hectares of degraded land by 2030. So there are no commitments by other countries. On the editorial page, the first editorial is irresponsible remarks. So this says that courts must remain wary of political moves to undermine the judiciary. So this is regarding the remark by a minister from Uttar Pradesh who said that the Supreme Court is ours, and the decision in the disputed site at Ayodhya, in that case, the ruling would be in favor of the Hindus. And then here you have ban of banners. So this is regarding illegal hoardings put up by politicians. It says these have become a threat to road users. Then the lead article is Afghan peace derailment, a wagon of hope. So this is regarding the suspension of US Taliban talks, which we have seen. So now a space for global community and India to reset the peace process has been opened up, which should be taken advantage of. And this is a milestone in greater transparency accountability. So this is regarding the Jan Suchna portal, which has been launched by Rajasthan. So it is said to be a vital cog in access to right to information. So this is like right to information means when you demand information is provided to you. But this Jan Suchna portal is where information is already out there for people to access in open. So this is the front page coverage and this is the article on that. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have a coverage on a particular issue. So today it is on value of discontent. So it's a ground zero coverage here. It says more than a month after Jammu and Kashmir lost its special constitutional status and statehood, people here are found to be distrustful of politicians and the media. And the effects of a lockdown by the state and shutdown called by protesters is being felt. On page 12, you have government plea against SC-ST Act verdict goes to 3-judge bench. So the Supreme Court has orders triggered a huge public backlash. So the government had filed a review petition on the order of the Supreme Court in March 2018. So the court's judgment would be referred to a 3-judge bench. And now this is the SC-ST case, where the dilution of the provisions of SC-ST Act was announced by the Supreme Court order. So a review petition has been heard. So it will be 3-judge bench which will hear this case. So it was 2-judge bench which had given this order, and now it will be referred to a three-judge bench. And this is, Supreme Court asks government if it plans to link social media Aadhaar. So such news had come forth, we had discussed it. So now Supreme Court is hearing Facebook's petition to bunch all Aadhaar cases on September 24th. So Supreme Court is asking the government on this issue as well. So this is very important. And this is, parliamentary panels have been delayed. So opposition says that notification which are expected have been given so far have not been given. Parliamentary panels have not been formed. The government says that the notification will come in few days. Then on page 13, you have big leap for naval variant of light combat aircraft Tejas. So this is regarding the light combat aircraft Tejas, of 4.5 generation lightweight multi-role fighter. So this is indigenously built by HAL, and now a naval variant of it has been developed. So these details of it are given here, the entire timeline. When DRDO actually got permission to build the jet was in 1983, and final operational clearance was in 2019. So naval variant made its maiden flight in 2012, and now it has performed arrested landing, that is the ability to land on an aircraft carrier. So that has been achieved. So aircraft carrier is actually a ship, a huge ship. It's an aircraft carrier. Then on international page, you have Carrie Lam promises housing reforms job. So Hong Kong protests are still continuing, and the chief administrator of Hong Kong still continues to give such minor concessions, like she's promising housing reforms jobs, which are highly unlikely to satisfy the protesters and the pro-democracy protests here. On business page, you have exports contract 6%, trade deficit widens marginally. So this is regarding how exports have contracted. Imports also witnessed contraction. Iron ore export has grown by 357%, however. You can see this is the trade deficit widening. Then here you have spectrum auction by year end or early next year, says Prasad. So this is Telecom Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad, who has said that India will launch its most awaited spectrum auction late in 2019 or early 2020. So this will be the largest auction ever to see 5G debut and sale of 4G spectrum as well. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs and to download the PDF for current affairs on a daily basis, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.